Oh God, ah! Give me strength.
I'm sorry.
This is a horrible.
I hate you. What are you doing to him? I hate you.
Stop. What has he done to you?
This is my dad. He's the reason I'm here. He taught me how to party and drink. He never took me to church. He's the reason I'm in hell. I hate you for it. I hate you. I hate you, Dad. I hate you.
This is a scene that'll be repeated over and over in hell. Sons chasing fathers, saying, why, Dad? Why didn't you take me to church? Why didn't you ever read the Bible to me? Why did you teach me how to drink, how to party, but you never taught me that there's a hell? Entire congregations will chase pastors and say, why? Why didn't you? All you did was preach the feel-good religion. Why didn't you warn me about hell? You know that the Bible actually teaches in Isaiah chapter 14 that the hell from beneath is moved at new people's coming. That when new people get to the gates of hell, that there are demon powers that stir up those inhabitants of hell, the souls in hell, stir them up and take them to the gate to watch the person that they knew in life and perhaps influenced. They watch them come into that awful place. I cannot imagine as a father being in hell and looking up and being stirred up by demons and being brought to the gates of hell and watch one of my children, one of my relatives coming to the place that I influenced them to come. It's an awful place. The Bible speaks of hell as a bottomless pit. It's a place, if you can imagine, where they're falling further and further away from God, away from joy, away from peace, away from any help, away from their family, away from any hope. Just as His mercy endures forever and forever and forever, so judgment has to match that. And that's why it's a bottomless pit. It goes on forever, falling further and further and further away from God, away from hope, away from help. On we go. On we go. Ah. I hear another unusual cry. Who is this man?
This is King Agrippa.
Yes. King Agrippa. The Bible said that one day the great Apostle Paul stood before King Agrippa in chains. He was in chains, and Agrippa had the armies behind him in power and prestige. Yet the Bible said the sermon that Paul preached to Agrippa that day caused Agrippa to tremble under conviction. He began to tremble. And when Paul preached, he said, almost you persuade me to become a Christian. Come at a more convenient season, Agrippa said. In other words, he was saying what many people say, not now. I want to do my thing. I want to live my life. I want to live like I want to live. Agrippa fully intended one day, someday, to give his heart to the Lord. And one of the theme songs of hell is almost. I almost went forward. I almost bowed my knee. I almost repented. Oh, if I could just have that chance back. But that convenient season never came in Agrippa's life. Understand this, every day that you live, your life is like a bank account. You can make no deposits, but every day that you live, you make one more withdrawal from the bank of time. And one day you'll make your last withdrawal, and suddenly you'll be thrust into eternity. And God help you if you've said one day, someday, tomorrow, The Bible said today is the day of salvation. And as we leave Him, we hear Him cry,
almost! Almost!
Don't wait too late. You're not promised tomorrow. Today is your day.
Jesus said, here I stand, won't you please let me in? And you said, I will tomorrow. Jesus said, I am He who supplies all you need. And you said, I know, but tomorrow.
Tomorrow, and very well.